So for this group work, our goal is to take an original data set, find the range, standard deviation, and variance. There's times where it asks us to use the population formula, there's times where it asks us to use the sample formula. For this first data set, it says to use the population formula. So the first thing that I'm gonna do is find the range. To find the range, I just take the largest number in the data set, which I identify as 9, minus the smallest number in the data set, which I identify as 0. When I do that, 9 minus 0 gives me 9. The next thing that I need to find is the mean. I'm using the symbol mu because it's from a population, because we were told this was the population. It still is the same formula as if I was doing a sample. I just take each data point, in this case 9, plus 6, plus 7, plus 5, plus 3, plus 2, plus 6, plus 0, and dividing it by the number of data points that I have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 data points, so I divide by 8. When I did that and I put that into my calculator, I got an answer of 4.75. That 4.75 is the mean, and it allows me to do my next step. My next step in the process is definitely the most complicated for students. Basically, I need to take each individual data point, subtract the mean, and square the result. So I did them in reordered form where I went smallest to largest. So I started with 0, then I had 2, 3, 5, 6, 6 again, 7, and 9. Each case, I subtract the mean that I found above. It would absolutely be fine if you rounded this to 4.8. Honestly, I'm just going off how I originally made the key, but I'm gonna do it based on 4.75 and then square the result. Minus 4.75, square the result, minus 4.75. So each time, in parentheses, I'm taking the data point, I'm subtracting the mean that I found, and then I'm squaring what happens afterwards. Because I'm squaring something in parentheses, whether it's a negative or a positive, it should always give me a positive answer. So be careful with the way that you're putting in this into your calculator. Make sure that if you do 0 minus 4.75 and get negative 4.75, when you go to square it, that negative is part of what's being squared. When I did this, I got 22.5625, 7.5625, 3.0625. Again, each of these is just the result of this squaring. 0.0625. Twice I got 1.5625, 1.5625. And then I got 5.0625 and 18.0625. So again, these are the results of the squaring. I'm going to more decimal places than maybe I really need to, just to show you that when you do this homework in WebAssign, they do make you go out to the number of decimal places that are available, where you don't want to round as you go to make it match up with the answer that they're going to get. You only want to really round in the process at the last step. So what we've done so far is we found the mean. We took each individual data point in the data set, subtracted the mean, and squared the result. We now want a total of these squared distances. So this sum of the squares, or when I add it all up, gives me a total of 59.5. From that 59.5, I can find the population variance, or sigma squared, by taking that 59.5 and dividing it by how many data points I had, 8. When I do that, I get a variance of 7.4375. This is the population variance that we were looking for. If we wanted to find the sample variance, which is not what we were looking for, S squared, the only difference would be that this 8, instead of being an 8, would be N minus 1 or 8 minus 1 that would make it 7. So everything else about the process would be the same. We'd find the mean the same way. We'd find the squared distances the same way. We'd total them the same way. The only difference between what we're doing at the top of the page when it's for a population and what we're doing at the bottom of the page when it's for a sample is whether we divide by N or divide by N minus 1. In either case, once we arrive at this variance, to get to sigma, or the standard deviation. We take what we got for sigma squared and take the square root of it. So I'm taking the square root of 7.4375. When I did that, I got an answer of 2.727. This is the standard deviation. And the way, again, I theoretically want you guys to understand that is that this data set is centered at 4.75, and on average, one data point is approximately 2.727 away from that center. For this second data set, we're again asked first to find the range. To find that range, I'm just going to take the largest data point that I see, 89, minus the smallest data point that I see, 21. When I do that, I get 68 as the range. So again, the range is just the largest number minus the smallest number. I then need to find the mean. In this case, for data set two, they asked us to find it for a sample, not a population. That's why I'm using X with a line over it, or X bar, to represent my mean, because we're treating it as a sample situation. Again, I'm gonna add together all of the numbers. So I'm just gonna do 89 plus 21 plus 50 plus 35 plus 21 plus 83 plus 50. I'm gonna divide that by how many data points I have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. When I did that, I got an answer of 49.86. Sorry, this marker's not great. Let's see if this other one's looking a little better. So I'm looking for 49.86. I now have to take each individual data point, subtract that mean of 49.86, and square the result. So in order, I'm gonna take 21, 21, 35, 50, 50, 83, and 89. Each time I'm gonna subtract 49.86 and square the result. 49.86, square the result. 49.86 squared, 49.86 squared, 49.86 squared, 49.86 squared, 49.86 squared. Again, I'm doing it out with more decimal places than really I probably would on the test. On the test, I probably, if I were you, call this like 49.9 to make it a little easier, but I'm trying to follow through with the same degree of specificity, if you'll allow it, basically to match up with how it will have to be in WebAssign to make it work. It's absolutely fine to in WebAssign. If you get to a final answer, you think you did the process correct, but maybe you rounded a little long way, send it to me as an Ask a Teacher. If it looks like it's just a rounding error, I'll send back what really should go in its place. So when I did these squares, the first thing that I got from 21 was 832.8996. Then I got another 832.8996. 220.8196, 0.0196, 0.0196, then 1098.2596, 1531.9396. Again, what I've done so far in the process is I found the mean of 49.86. I've taken each individual data point, subtracted that mean, and squared the result. I now have each of those squared results here for the seven data points. I total them or take their sum. When I do that, I get a total of 4516.8572. This is the sum of squared distances. In order to then take this and find the variance for the sample, or S squared, that variance is gonna be based off 4516.8572. divided by, instead of just 7 like it was for our population example, 7 minus 1. When I did that out, I got an answer of 752.8095. This is my variance for the sample, 752.8095. If I want to find the standard deviation, I do the same thing I did when it was a population. I take the square root of the variance to get back to standard deviation. When I do that, the square root of 752.8095 gets me to an answer of 27.437. So the variance is 752.8095. The standard deviation is 27.437. For this third data set, we start out with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 800. If we want to find the range of this data set, we're going to take the largest number, 800, minus the smallest number, 1. That gives me 799 as a range. Here they've asked us to do the population variance and population standard deviation. So if we're doing that, we're going to be looking for the mean of a population by finding the addition of all these 8 numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 800, all being divided by the number of data points I have, 8. When I put this in my calculator, I got 828 divided by 8, which gave me 103.5. The next step in the process to find population variance is to take each individual data point, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 800, subtract that mean that I found of 103.5, square the result, minus 103.5 squared, 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 minus 103.5 squared. When I did this, I got answers of 10,506.25, 10,302.25, 10,100.25, 9,900.25, 9,702.25, 9,506.25, 9,312.25, and finally 485,112.25. When I totaled everything up, I got 554,442. So I know these are really big numbers. Really, this data set is meant to show how much an outlier can impact the variance and standard deviation. So here we have a bunch of numbers clumped up down. This would have a mean of 4 if I just took the first 7, and then we toss in an 800. That's why these square distances got so large, and really why the sum of the squares, when we turn it into a variance, will still be pretty large. So to turn that into a variance or a sigma squared, we're going to take that total, 554,442, and divide it by how many data points we have, 8. When I did that, I got a population variance of 69,305.25. To find the sample, or the population standard deviation, I'm going to take the square root of that number, the square root of 69,305.25. And when I did that, I got a final answer of 263.259. For this fourth data set, find the range. I again find the largest number in the data set, 12, minus the smallest number, 3. That gives me the range of 9. To start the process to find the sample variance and sample standard deviation, I need the sample mean, or X bar. I find that by adding together all the data points, 8 plus 9 plus 10 plus 12 plus 4 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 10, and dividing by how many data points I have, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. When I did that, I got an answer of 7.56. I then need to take each individual data point and subtract that 7.56. So in order, they were 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 12. Each time, I'm going to be subtracting 7.56 from these data points and then squaring the result. When I put these into the calculator, I got answers of 20.7936, 12.6736, 6.5536, 0.3136, 0.1936, 2.0736, 5.9536, 5.9536 again, and finally 19.7136. I added these 9 squared distances together and got a total of 74.2224. When I now go to find the variance of that sample, the variance, or S squared, is going to equal to the 74.2224 being divided by n minus 1, or 9 minus 1. Again, both ways are represented in the homework, both ways represented in class, but this sample version of the formula is the way they'll be presented on the test. When I take this and divide by really 8, I get a sample variance of 9.2778. I can then find the sample standard deviation S by taking the square root of that, 9.2778. When I did that, I got a final answer of 3.046.